Hi guys, the one who works very hard will never go unrewarded. The efforts that you make today will bear fruits in the coming days. So don't give up, don't lose your spirit, and keep on working hard. And one day, during the day of results, you will see the flowering results in your hands, so that it will make you and your parents and all the close and dear ones so happy about your performance, about your life. Good. In the last lesson, we have studied about the bhakti and Sufi traditions. In Brahmanical traditions, because of the complexity involved in it, there was a group of people emerging advocating for personal devotion with God, like Alvars and Nayanars, Virubakshas, Lingayats from Karnataka, and we also talked about Jogis, Naths from North India. Then, from the perspective of Islam, another group of people called Sufis, who created their own silsilas to achieve that personal devotion with God. Then we talked about Islam and its principles and Sufis and their way of life and all that we studied in that last lesson. It's very, very informative and knowledgeable lesson it was. And I hope you understood some of the core concepts. It involved a lot of MCQs and one markers, which you need to revise again and again. Without taking short notes, you cannot master that lesson. You have to take short notes and revise every now and then. When we have our live session, in the next, maybe next week, Wednesday, we will be having the live session, and I will be revising the lesson Bhakti and Sufi traditions, in which I will focus more on Islam, since it is little complicated. So we will be having focusing more on Islam and its Sufi and its silsilas and all that. Fine. Now we have a new chapter. We are going to start a new chapter, which is comparatively easy and interesting, plus important also. This chapter talks about a very important strong kingdom from southern part of India. This is Vijayanagara Empire. We must have heard about this, Vijayanagara Empire. This is the imperial capital, Vijayanagara, the name of the chapter. And it was founded in the 14th century. It had its own decline or fall in the 17th century. So, three centuries they had their own rule, and they paid a lot of attention to architecture, literature, plus giving a good or important and very, very a sensible rule to the people, understanding the problems of the people. Their main focus was on temple building and architecture, and fortifying their own empire. Fine, with this short introduction, let us see some of the facts in this introduction. That is, Vijayanagara is also called a city of victory. So, which place is known as City of Victory? This is Vijayanagara. Okay, this is the name for both city as well as an empire. Okay, so for an empire, Vijayanagara agar bolenge to empire ko bhi indicate karta hai, aur city ka bhi naam Vijayanagara hai, Vijayanagara. Okay, at that time. So this was founded in 14th century, as I told you. It is stretched from, in its heyday. Heyday means successful time. Okay, in its heyday, jab wo bahut successful tha, us samay Vijayanagara Empire stretched from it stretched from river Krishna to north, in the north, and to the extreme south of peninsula, even to the Tamil Nadu, present day Tamil Nadu, wahan tak Vijayanagara Empire ka aur rulers ka rule tha jab wo apne successful peak time mein the. So in 1565 the city was sacked and subsequently deserted and all that. It fell into ruin in 17th century. Fine. So we'll see rest of the things. Yeah, this fact is also important. They remembered, okay, it as Vijayanagara Empire ko aaj bhi Hampi ke naam pe jana jata hai. People remember this as a Hampi because the name derived from that local mother goddess is called Pamba Devi. Hampi Pamba Devi. So it is coming from Hampi is coming from Pamba Devi. So Pamba Devi goddess ke naam pe ye area. Now Hampi is a village. Actually, it is a village present day. It has a kind of a kind know a vast complex of temples. It consists of so many temples in a complex, in a building, sorry, in a circular platform. So it has got a lot of temples. Hampi is known for a lot of temples like Pamba Devi temple, Virubaksha temple. We will be studying about all these temples in one of the topics in this lesson. Fine. So they may ask this question. Hampi is deriving its name from local mother goddesses Pamba Devi. Please underline this. Now, the discovery of Hampi, how was it for the first time discovered by the historians or anybody? So this person named Colonel Colin McKenzie, we studied about him in the last lesson also, previous lesson, I think this stupas ke bare mein jab hum pad rahe the, so we I think studied about this name of this person. He is the one who brought this to light. He was an engineer plus antiquarian, you know, studying about the antiquity, old things, ancient things ke bare mein padhne wala. So he brought this. He was an employee of English East India Company and he prepared the first survey map of the site. He only prepared this, and the information as he received was based, jo bhi information isko mila, it is based on the memories of the priests of Virubaksha temple and the shrine of Pamba Devi. Pamba Devi and Virubaksha temple mein 18th सेंचुरी के बाद जो प्रीस्ट वहां रहते थे, जो भी वहां काम करते थे, उनके मेमोरी से जो भी इंफॉर्मेशन निकाला गया, दैट इज द इनिशियल फर्स्ट हैंड इंफॉर्मेशन दैट ही हैड. सब्सिक्वेंटली फ्रॉम 1856 द फोटोग्राफर्स बिगन टू रिकॉर्ड द मॉन्यूमेंट्स व्हिच एनेबल द स्कॉलर्स टू स्टडी देम. From 1836, epigraphs who study the inscriptions collected so many inscriptions from that site, and you know, they reconstruct the history of the city and the empire and all that. They collected all the informations, collated means assembled all the information from these sources and account from the foreigners as well as travelers and all that, and they load up so many literatures and from Telugu, Kannada, Tamil and Sanskrit in all these languages. So this is about the discovery of Hampi. Yes, one marker ke liye padna, I don't think so any question can come in this, but yes, of course, so many one markers based on the whose memory it was first hand information by Colonel Colin McKenzie can be a question, and who brought this to light, this is also McKenzie only. So all these things you need to know. Fine. So first source about Colin McKenzie, he was born in 1754. Colin McKenzie became very famous as an engineer, surveyor and cartographer. Cartographer is the one who makes charts and maps about a particular place. So cartographer. In 1815, he was appointed the first surveyor general of India. Very, very important. ठीक है, ये source में है, but ये question one marker में भी आ सकते हैं, क्योंकि somewhere it is mentioned. So first surveyor general of India is McKenzie. A post he held till his death. He embarked on collecting, depended on collecting local histories. He did all the work in collecting the old local histories, surveying the historical sites in order to better understand India's past and make governance. Why he was interested in doing all these things? This is the reason, because to understand, so that the Britishers can understand India's past and make governance more easier. So he says that it struggled long under the miseries and of bad management. India, it means India struggled under the bad management before the South came under the Bengin influence of British government. Jab tak, so influence of pura South, it had lot of mismanagement and all that. Jab tak Britishers nahi aaya, tab tak yahan pe bahut problems the. By studying Vijayanagara, McKenzie believed that the East Indian Company could gain much useful information of many of these institutions, laws and customs, whose influence still prevails among the various tribes of natives forming the general mass of the population up to this day. By understanding Vijayanagara, by studying Vijayanagara, they could gain lot of knowledge so that they can make their own laws and customs for the local population, especially tribal people. So this is a source, a very important source. Okay, please read this at least two or three times. Now we are getting into the core lesson. Rayas, Nayakas and Sultans. See, Rayas, the Vijayanagara rulers are also called as Rayas. Nayakas are those people who are local chiefs giving military support to the rayas. They are called nayakas. We'll study about all this in this. I'm just summarizing, telling you what it is. And sultans, yeah, we have three Deccan sultans from Bijapur, Golconda, and Ahmednagar. So all these, people are involved in the running of Vijayanagara Empire. So we are going to see all these people. Okay. According to traditions, epigraphic evidence, according to the tradition and the epigraphic evidence, we have two brothers, Harihara and Bukka. The tradition, the historical traditions and epigraphical evidence says that these are the two brothers who founded the Vijayanagara Empire in 1336. Year is very important and the brothers' name are very important. And these are the founder members of Vijayanagara Empire. Very, very important question. One marker hai. 1336. This empire included kahan se kahan tak within its fluctuating frontiers. Frontiers means boundaries. No, ye koi fix nahi tha ki ek bar found kiya gaya aur last tak waise hi tha boundary line, because it was fluctuating, because so many times so many invaders came and attacked and conquered some of the boundaries. So it was fluctuating, and people had so many languages. People spoke many languages and many religion. So southern part of India, if you remember, and if you know that, so many different languages spoken. It's not unlike North India. South India has got so many highly liturgical languages, and people of that time also spoke all these languages, and the Vijayanagara Empire ruled all this place. On their northern frontier, the Vijayanagara kings, north boundary mein Vijayanagara Empire ka competition kon de raha tha? The kings competed with the contemporary rulers, including Sultans of Deccan. Okay, and Sultans of Deccan, we will see all these three sultans are there. We will study. So Sultans of Deccan and Gajapati rulers of Orissa. These are the two people north side in quite tough competition. Why they were fighting? They were fighting to control the fertile river valleys and the resources. Questions. See, one marker can come at any type. Okay. So why there was a continuous fight between the Deccan sultans of Deccan and Gajapati rulers with Vijayanagara Empire? Because to have control over the fertile river valleys and the resources generated by lucrative overseas trade. The southern part is surrounded by oceans, seas. So there is overseas trade, so much trade, and it is attractive trade. Lucrative means very, very attractive, so much of money. So they wanted to have control over this area. At the same time, interaction between these two states led to sharing of ideas, especially the field of architecture. Trade karne ke karan hamare ideas both improve, especially in architecture. The rulers of Vijayanagara borrowed concepts and building techniques which then developed further. So all these things. So this is about frontiers, boundary line mein kiske saath inka ye tha and all that. Okay, fine. See, this is given, this photo, Mackenzie. It's a copy by an unknown artist, this one, portrait. It dates that belongs to the collection of Royal Asiatic Society of Britain and Ireland. Okay, so read girl, I don't think so it is important. Fine. Karnataka Samrajya. While historians use the term Vijayanagara Empire, contemporaries of that time, okay, us samay jo contemporaries the, Deccan sultans of Deccan and Gajapati rulers and all others, they described it as a Karnataka Samrajyam. Karnataka Samrajyam. So today historians talk about this because it is not just include the present day Karnataka, it includes even the southern part, so many other states also. So it is, today we call this as a Vijayanagara Empire. The historians call this like this, but the contemporaries that time described it as a Karnataka Samrajyam. So people of Karnataka are very proud of this Vijayanagara Empire because most of the important places are lying within the state of Karnataka. Fine, that's just a quick important fact. Fine. Some of the areas that were incorporated within the empire had witnessed the development of powerful states, such as jo area inke control mein tha. उसी एरिया में से बाद में कुछ साल बाद कुछ डिफरेंट इंपॉर्टेंट रूलर्स और आए, लाइक चोलास इन तमिलनाडु एंड होयसालास ऑफ कर्नाटका. ये दोनों जो पावरफुल रूलर्स हैं जो विजयनगर एम्पायर के कंट्रोल में जो एरिया था उसी एरिया के अंतर्गत ये लोग बाद में अपने नो दे स्टार्टेड रूलिंग. ओके सो चोलास एंड होयसालास रूलिंग अलाइट्स इन दिस एरियाज एंड एक्सटेंडेड पैटर्नज टू एलाबोरेट टेम्पल सच एज. सो रूलर्स ऑफ दिस एरिया गेव देयर पैटर्नेज टू बृहदीश्वर टेम्पल तंजावूर दिस एंड चेन्नकेश्वर टेम्पल इन बेलूर, बेलूर इन कर्नाटका एंड तंजूर इट इज कॉल्ड तंजावूर एंड इन इंग्लिश तंजूर इट इज इन तमिलनाडु. So this Cholas gave patronage to Brahadishwara temple in Tanjavur and Chennakeshwar temple. This Hoysalas gave patronage to Chennakeshwar temple in Belur. So rulers of Vijayanagara who called themselves Rayas built on these traditions and carried them. Okay, so some of the areas that Oh, I'm very sorry. See, actually, it is not that Vijayanagara Empire ke baad ye Cholas or Hoysalas came up. It is from Cholas and Hoysalas. Earlier, Cholas were ruling. They were ruling actually. Cholas ruled the 9th century to 11th and 12th century. So that is a peak time for Cholas. तो चोलास जहाँ पे रूल करते थे उसी एरिया विजयनगर एम्पायर में बाद में 14th सेंचुरी में आया. सो एंड होयसालास जहाँ पे कर्नाटक में रूल करते थे. सो दिस पीपल वेयर नॉट द सक्सेसर्स ऑफ विजयनगर एम्पायर्स बट दिस पीपल आर प्रेडिसेसर्स मतलब विजयनगर एम्पायर रूलर्स के पहले ये लोग थे. सो ये जो पैटर्नेज टेम्पल्स को देते थे वही ट्रेडिशन को इन लोगों ने आगे और बनाए रखा. सो दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस. So these people, the Vijayanagara Empire rulers also continued in giving patronage to all these rulers. So that is about first topic we have taken this introduction in Rayas and Nayakas. इसमें जो introduction था, I don't frame any question on this, but so many things are there for you to be asked in MCQs like Brahadeshwara Temple, where is it located? Chennakeshwar Temple कहाँ है? And rulers of Vijayanagara call themselves Rayas. Rayas कौन है? So all these things can come in your MCQs. So here this is an important MCQ again. Elephants, horses, and men. Gajapati literally, Gajapati rulers of Orissa we say. Gajapati literally means lord of elephants. This was the name for a ruling lineage that was very powerful in Odisha. And in the popular traditions of Vijayanagara, the Deccan sultans are termed as Ashwapati or lord of horses. ओके वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ये डेक्कन्स ऑफ सुल्तान्स कॉल दमसेल्स एज अश्वपति एंड गजपति द रूलर्स ऑफ ओडिशा एंड वी हैव रायास दे कॉल दमसेल्स एज नारपति. सो सो नारपति लॉर्ड ऑफ मेन दिस पीपल आर नो लॉर्ड लॉर्ड फॉर द मेन द पीपल. सो लॉर्ड ऑफ द पीपल इज रायास. लॉर्ड ऑफ द हॉर्सेस इज अश्वपति दैट इज डेक्कन ऑफ सुल्तान्स. Gajapati is the lord of elephants. So these are a question can come on this. Okay, MCQs में वो match match में दे सकते हैं. One side Gajapati, the other side they can give lord of elephants and all that. So Narapati is confusing, but the rest is Ashwapati also lord of horses. Fine. So that is about the introduction about this. Now kings and traders. A warfare during this time dependent upon the effective cavalry. One who has got the army, he is the one who is going to rule over the place. And the import of the horses from Arabia and Central Asia was also an important rival kingdoms. So it depends how much army you have and how much horses you have. And and this is इसमें depend होता है कि आप जीतोगे कि नहीं. This trade was initially controlled by Arab traders. पहले अरब ट्रेडर्स इस ट्रेड को जो नो ट्रेड ऑफ हॉर्सेस वॉज कंट्रोल्ड बाई दिस पीपल बट लोकल कम्युनिटीज ऑफ मर्चेंट्स नोन एज कुदरे चेटीज और द हॉर्स मर्चेंट्स. सी कुदरे इन तमिल मीनिंग हॉर्स, चेटीज मीन्स मर्चेंट्स. सो कुदरे चेटीज और हॉर्स मर्चेंट्स ऑल्सो पार्टिसिपेटेड इन दिस एक्सचेंजेस. पहले अरब भी कैंडल हैंडल करते थे, लेटर ऑन local merchants also involved in this. From 1498 other actors appeared on the scene. These were for the Portuguese who arrived on the west coast of Portuguese also involved in this trade purpose to establish trading and military stations. their superior military technology, especially the use of muskets, elephants, okay, elephants, muskets meaning elephants, enabled them to become the important players in the tangled politics of this period. So Portuguese came to India by 1498, that is almost in the end of 15th century, and they emerged as the very important player in the even in every perspective, the trader perspective as well as ruling perspective. So this is how the kings and the traders trade, and king dependent, if any king is powerful, depends on his effective cavalry and the number of horses that he has, and the number of horses he is able to buy from Asia, Central Asia and Arabia. So this is how. In fact, Vijayanagara was also noted for its markets dealing in spices, textiles and precious stones. This was often regarded as a status symbol for such cities, which bolstered a wealthy population that demanded high value exotic goods, especially precious. So it depends, if a city is very famous, agar famous hona hai, to how much would, that city is able to deal in precious stones, spices, how much they are able to buy and sell. Jewelry made sabme, okay, depends. So the revenue is from this in turn contributed significantly to the prosperity of the state. So in Vijayanagara was also, the rulers of Vijayanagara also had a lot of, people of Vijayanagara had a lot of markets dealing in spices, textiles and precious stones. Fine. So that is about kings and traders. Again, there is no any short answers. You can just read them for your MCQs and all that. Year is very important. 1498 Portuguese came. 1336 Vijayanagara Empire was founded. 14th century to 17th century Vijayanagara, and Cholas and Hoysalas, they were the predecessors, Ashwapati, Gajapati and Narapati. So three patis we have. Then Karnataka Samrajyam, and we talked about this also, and Harihara Bukka we talked about. So yes, these are some of the important facts and figures so far we discussed. Read them please at least 2-3 times from your book. After attending the videos, watching the videos, you have to read. The first question comes, the apogee and decline of the empire. Vijayanagara Empire ka peak time ek tha, us wo aur decline. Ye pura ek story. Now we are going to see the elements. Yeah, you can say explain the apogee and the decline of the empire. Apogee means peak time. Inka jo Vijayanagara Empire ka jo peak time tha, wo kab tha aur kiske time mein tha aur inka decline kaise hua. So that is all about explain or elaborate the apogee and decline of the empire can is the question. It is a long answer. Within the polity means governance. Claimants, one who trying to have power over. To power included members of the ruling lineage as well as military commanders. Matlab Vijayanagara Empire mein aisa nahi ki we had Islamic rulers like Mughals, you had Delhi Sultanate, the son after father, then son, then like that. It is not like this. Anybody who is able to win over ruling lineage, though matlab ruler banenge sahi. लेकिन अगर वो कोई रूलर पपट रूलर अच्छा रूलर नहीं है, पावरफुल नहीं है, तो मिलिट्री कमांडर्स आल्सो कैन बिकम द रूलर्स इफ दे आर कैपेबल एंड एबल टू विन ओवर देयर किंग. सो द फर्स्ट डायनेस्टी नोन एज द संगमा डायनेस्टी दैट हरिहरा बुकान वी टॉक्ड अबाउट, द टू ब्रदर्स, दे बिलोंग टू अ डायनेस्टी. डायनेस्टी मीन्स अ फैमिली, ओके, जो सरनेम आता है ना फैमिली. सो संगमा डायनेस्टी से वो लोग बिलोंग करते थे. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है ये, बहुत बार एग्जाम में आया हुआ है. द फर्स्ट रूलिंग डायनेस्टी ऑफ विजयनगर एम्पायर इज Sangama dynasty, exercised power up to 1485. Okay, so 1336 they founded, and almost 1030-40 years they ruled. They were supplanted, means removed, by another dynasty called Salua dynasty. Salua dynasty. So military commanders who remained, so these were not ruling lineage Saluas, they are military commanders who remained in power for another 20 years, not 18 years, when they were replaced by another dynasty called Tuluwa dynasty. So the very famous and important king of Vijayanagara Empire called Krishna Devaraya, you must have studied in lot of short stories, Krishna Devaraya belonged to Tuluwa dynasty. A question, both मतलब बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है कि कृष्ण देवराया बिलोंग टू विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग डायनेस्टी, संगमा डायनेस्टी, तुलुवा डायनेस्टी एंड सलुवा डायनेस्टी. ही बिलोंग्स टू तुलुवा डायनेस्टी. इज एन वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड ऑब्वियस इजी इजी क्वेश्चन है ये. और ये क्वेश्चन ये भी आ सकते हैं, व्हाट आर दिस वर्ड्स, व्हाट डू ऑल दिस वर्ड्स मीन, संगमा, सलुवा एंड तुलुवा, ऑल दीज आर विजयनगर एम्पायर डायनेस्टीज है. ऑप्शन में कोई ना कोई सेंटेंस ऐसा होगा जो विजयनगर एम्पायर के बारे में बात करेगा. सो दैट वुड बी द आंसर. सो वी हैव सीन एन इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्ट. नाउ कृष्ण देवराया रूल वॉज कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाई एक्सपेंशन एंड कंसॉलिडेशन. कृष्ण देवराया जो रूल करते थे उनका एक ही मकसद था कि एक्सपैंड करना, जितना भी आपने एक्सपैंड किया उसको कंसॉलिडेट करना. दिस वॉज द टाइम इन द लैंड बिटवीन तुंगभद्रा रिवर एंड द कृष्णा रिवर. सी तुंगभद्रा रिवर इन द सदर्न पार्ट ऑफ यू नो तमिलनाडु, इट इज ऑलमोस्ट एट द एंड यू नो आंध्र प्रदेश में है. वेयर एज कृष्णा रिवर इट इज इवन इन महाराष्ट्र थोड़ा बहुत है. सो इफ यू कैन सी द मैप, सो इट इज बिटवीन दिस तुंगभद्रा रिवर कृष्णा रिवर, दैट दोनों के बीच में जो द्वाब है, दोनों रिवर के बीच में जो द्वाब है, दैट इज रायचूर द्वाब. द्वाब मीन्स लैंड बिटवीन टू रिवर्स. द्वाब दो मीन्स टू एंड अब मीन्स रिवर. सो दोआब मीनिंग लैंड बिटवीन टू रिवर्स, रायचूर दोआब कहते हैं उसको. वॉज अक्वायर्ड बाई हिम एंड रूलर्स ऑफ ओरिसा वर सबड्यूड. द गजपति रूलर्स ऑफ ओरिसा वर सबड्यूड, ही डिफीटेड दम एंड सिवियर डिफीट्स ऑल्सो इन्फ्लिक्टेड टू द सुल्तान ऑफ बीजापुर. बीजापुर सुल्तान को भी इन्होंने हराया. सो ही वॉज एक्सपैंडिंग द टेरिटरी लाइक एनीथिंग. Although the kingdom, so this is the apogee of the period. See, we are talking about the apogee of the empire, decline of the empire. Next paragraph. So this is the apogee. Apogee में ये points अब आपको लिखना पड़ेगा. Expansion and consolidation, Tungabhadra, Raichur, Doha के बारे में, Orissa rulers subdued means defeated, sultans of Bijapur defeated. Although the kingdom remained in a constant state of military preparedness, it flourished under the conditions of unparalleled peace and prosperity. हमेशा military war बैटल में ही थे कृष्ण देवराय. बट इवन देन इट हैड लॉट ऑफ पीस एंड प्रॉस्पेरिटी इन हिज टाइम. सो कृष्ण देवराय इज क्रेडिटेड इज रिमेम्बर्ड फॉर मेनी थिंग्स. क्रेडिटेड विथ बिल्डिंग सम फाइन टेम्पल्स एंड एडिंग इम्प्रेसिव गोब्रम्स टू मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सदर्न इंडियन टेम्पल्स. नो लॉट ऑफ बहुत सारे टेम्पल बनाए और बहुत सारे टेम्पल्स में इन्होंने गोब्रम्स एड किए. He also founded a suburban township near Vijayanagara called Nagalapuram. This Nagalapuram is named after his mother. Okay, so mother name must be Nagalamma or something. I am not very sure. So he is naming a new town, suburban. मतलब विजयनगर एम्पायर से थोड़ा सा दूर एक suburban township वो बना रहे हैं और उनका नाम Nagalapuram रखते हैं. Some of the most detailed descriptions of Vijayanagara come from his time and just after. So Vijayanagara Empire में अगर peak time कुछ था वो कृष्ण देवराय के time में ही था. So apogee का answer हमने किया है अभी. Strain began to show within the imperial structure after the death of Vijayanagara Empire in 1529. Year बहुत important है. 1529 was the death of कृष्ण देवराय. His successors were troubled by rebellious. तो successors जो भी आए छोटे मोटे rulers थे तो वो इन लोगों से नायकास. आई टोल्ड यू द मिलिट्री चीफ्स. ओके, नायकास आर मिलिट्री चीफ्स. इनके बारे में हम नेक्स्ट पढ़ेंगे हम. सो रिबेलियस नायकास वो बहुत ट्रबल करते थे. बाय 1542 द कंट्रोल एट द सेंटर हैड शिफ्टेड टू अनदर रूलिंग लीनिएज कॉल्ड अरवीडु. नाउ दिस इज द फोर्थ रूलिंग डायनेस्टी कॉल्ड अरवीडु डायनेस्टी. सो फर्स्ट ये क्रोनोलॉजिकल ऑर्डर में भी पूछ सकते हैं. फर्स्ट इट इज संगमा, देन सलुवा, देन तुलुवा, देन अरवीडु. तो 1522 के बाद एक ऐसा एक रूलिंग डायनेस्टी ने रूल अपने हाथ में लिया, वो है अरवीडु डायनेस्टी, विच रिमेंड इन पावर टिल द एंड ऑफ द 17th सेंचुरी. सो दिस आर द फोर डायनेस्टीज, इंपॉर्टेंट डायनेस्टीज. लास्ट तक अरवीडु रूल करा. ड्यूरिंग दिस पीरियड एज इंडीड अर्लियर द मिलिट्री एम्बिशंस ऑफ द रूलर्स ऑफ विजयनगर एज वेल एज दोस ऑफ डेक्कन रिजल्टेड इन शिफ्टिंग अलाइनमेंट्स. तो दोनों डेक्कन सुल्तानेट्स को भी और विजयनगर रूलर्स को भी ऐसा एक एम्बिशन, मिलिट्री एम्बिशन आ गया कि बहुत सारे एरिया को कवर करना है, कंट्रोल करना है. सो दे स्टार्टेड फाइटिंग फ्रीक्वेंटली. कृष्ण देवराय के टाइम में इतना फाइट सुल्तान ऑफ डेक्कन के साथ नहीं था बिकॉज समटाइम्स ही हैड गुड रिलेशंस विद सम ऑफ द सुल्तान्स. बट नो बट हियर ऑल द सुल्तान्स, ऑल द थ्री सुल्तान्स, नो दे हैड दिस नो दे स्टार्टेड शिफ्टिंग देयर अलाइनमेंट्स. कभी बीजापुर, कभी दिस फेलो सो इज दैट गजपति रूलर्स ऑफ ओडिशा के पास उनके साथ रहते हैं, कभी Vijayanagara Empire. So the Sultan started changing their alignments again and again. Eventually, this led to an alliance. So ye alliance ban gaya of the Sultanates against Vijayanagara. All the Sultans came together to fight with. ये लास्ट में ऐसा एक सिचुएशन देखना पड़ा विजयनगर रूलर्स को नो दैट ऑल द थ्री सुल्तान्स केम टुगेदर अगेंस्ट विजयनगर इन 1565 द रामराया वाज द चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ विजयनगर ही वाज द रूलर ऑफ विजयनगर लेड द आर्मी इनटू द बैटल कॉल्ड राक्षसी तंगाड़ी आल्सो नोन एज तालीकोटा वेयर हिज फोर्सेस वेर राउटेड बाय द कंबाइंड आर्मीज ऑफ बीजापुर अहमदनगर एंड गोलकोंडा So three sultans of Bijapur, Ahmednagar, and Golconda came together to defeat the Vijayanagara Empire ruler, who was the ruler of that time is Ramaraya. He belonged to Aravidu dynasty. In 1565, they had an important battle called Rakshasi Tangadi. This battle is also known by other name called Talikota. So this his forces, the Ramaraya's forces were routed, defeated by the combined forces. Armies of three sultans. This the victorious armies sank the city of Vijayanagara. The city was totally abandoned within few years. Now the focus of the empire shifted to the east, where Aravidu dynasty ruled from Benukonda and later from Chandragiri near Tirupati. So main cities of Chodchadke Aravidu में जो छोटा मोटा जो rulers बचे हुए थे, वो लोग जाके Chandragiri area में रूल करने लग गए नीचे जाके बाकी ऊपर का जो एरिया है ऑल दिस इफ यू कैन सी हियर ऑल दिस तुंगभद्रा रिवर ओके तुंगभद्रा रिवर इज हियर एंड कृष्णा रिवर इज हियर सो तुंगभद्रा एंड कृष्णा एंड दिस इज द एरिया नो दिस इज द एरिया फॉर नो कॉल्ड रायचूर दुआब तो यहाँ ये मेन इनका रूल इधर था सी बीजापुर बीजापुर इज हियर ओके बीजापुर इज गिवन गोलकोंडा इज गिवन यस देन वन मोर Ahmednagar is it given? So these are the sultans, okay? And Golconda and Gulbarga and all sultans, okay? So Vijayanagara, that's Hyderabad, Chitragur, Ikri, Kolar, Chandragiri, Kanchipuram, Mysore. All these were not under the control of Vijayanagara Empire, but later on it all got a decline. So we are seeing the decline of Vijayanagara Empire. So after this battle, it was just reduced to a small ruling group in Penugunda and later on in Chandragiri. So this is about apogee and this is about the decline. We have seen two important question. Now iska conclusion. Ye long answer hai. Iska conclusion bhi hona chahiye na. At last, what do the historians say about this battle? See, although the armies of sultans were responsible for the destruction of the city. Relation between sultans and rayas were not always and inevitably hostile in spite of religious differences. See, Vijayanagara rulers were Hindus, whereas sultans were Muslims. Irrespective of their religious difference, they were not always hostile. Unke beech mein hamesha ek aisa hostility jaise ek situation nahi exist hota tha. They were sometimes good friends. No, but depends on the rulers of that time. For example, Krishna Devaraya, when he was the ruler, Krishna Devaraya, for example, supported some claimants power in sultans and took pride in the title called establisher of Yavana kingdom. So, agar like jaise Bijapur hai, Golconda hai, Ahmednagar hai, inke jo sultans mein kaun next sultan banega, isme agar koi problem aaya power attain karne mein. ये जाके उनको मतलब समझौता कर देते उनको ही वॉज एबल टू नो कन्विंस द पीपल एंड द मिनिस्टर्स एंड मेक नो मेक समबडी हु इज कैपेबल उसको सुल्तान बनाने में हेल्प करते थे दैट इज व्हाई ही इज कॉल्ड एंड टाइटल्ड एज एस्टैब्लिशर ऑफ यावना किंगडम यावना वी दिस इज द वर्ड वी यूज्ड नो वी स्टडीड अर्लियर यावना इज अ संस्कृत वर्ड यूज्ड फॉर द ग्रीक्स एंड अदर पीपल सो दिस सुल्तान्स केम फ्रॉम Center now from southwest Asia, so they are all sometimes Greeks. They know this. That is why he is the establisher of Yavana kingdom in India. Similarly, Sultan of Bijapur intervened. Another example to resolve the succession disputes in Vijayanagara following the death of Krishna Devaraya. So sometimes sultans came forward to help. Which is Krishna Devaraya's death ke baad. जो छोटे मोटे रूलर्स के बीच में जब भी कोई प्रॉब्लम होता था तो दे केम टू रिसॉल्व द सक्सेशन डिस्प्यूट्स. सी हाउ मच दे हैड इन देयर रिलेशन, गिव एंड टेक, हेल्प्ड ईच अदर इन यू नो इन रनिंग द किंगडम एम्पायर स्मूथली. बट देन व्हाट मेड दिस राक्षस तंगाड़ी बैटल टू टेक प्लेस? व्हाट वाज द कॉज फॉर राक्षस तंगाड़ी लाइक बैटल, सच अ हॉरिबल बैटल टू टेक प्लेस? इन फैक्ट this is the main reason. Okay, the main reason, in fact, the Vijayanagara rulers were very keen to ensure the stability of the sultan's vice versa. Okay, ye sab usme ho gaya. This is the main reason why the battle took place. It was the adventurous policy of Rama Raya, who tried to play off one sultan against another, that led the sultans to combine together and decisively defeat him. To uska ye crookedness tha, क्रुकटनेस, रामराया का क्रुकटनेस, विच यू नो इफ इट वॉज ट्राइंग टू प्ले ऑफ विद वन सुल्तान पुटिंग द अदर सुल्तान, इसका इसके बारे में उसको, सो दैट मेड ऑल द थ्री सुल्तान्स एंग्री एंड बिकम नो इरिटेटेड अबाउट दिस एंड दे केम टूगेदर इन द बैटल कॉल्ड राक्षस तंगाड़ी. अदरवाइज देर वॉज नो बैटल कॉल्ड राक्षस तंगाड़ी एक्सिस्टिंग इन द हिस्ट्री. इट वॉज बिकॉज ऑफ दिस वन पर्सन रामराया दिस बैटल हैड टू टेक प्लेस. And the Vijayanagara Empire, a great Vijayanagara Empire, came to decline. So this is the last conclusion you have to write about the Rayas and the Nayakas. The another question. So this is write a short note on Amara Nayaka system. That's the question. Okay. ये question answer यहाँ से start होगा actually. Amara Nayaka system question यहाँ से start होगा. सॉरी आंसर, लेकिन उससे पहले हम एक इंट्रोडक्शन देखेंगे. एक क्वेश्चन हमने अभी तक इस लेसन में देखा है, वो है एक्सप्लेन द अपोजी एंड डिक्लाइन ऑफ द विजयनगर एम्पायर. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, इट्स अ लॉन्ग आंसर. इनमें से कोई शॉर्ट आंसर भी आ सकता है कि यू नो व्हाट इज राक्षस तंगाड़ी एंड व्हाट वाज द मेन कॉज फॉर दिस राक्षस तंगाड़ी. एनीथिंग कैन बी आस्क्ड, सो बी रेडी फॉर दैट. अमंग दोज हु एक्सरसाइज पावर इन द एम्पायर वर मिलिट्री चीफ्स हु यूजुअली कंट्रोल्ड फोर्ट्स and had armed supporters. Okay, so military chiefs वही control करते हैं और armed सब. These chiefs were often moved from one area to another, and in many cases were accompanied by peasants. So they were moving from one another, and they had peasants looking after their fertile land and all that. These chiefs were known as Nayakas. I told you who are Nayakas. Rayas हमने देख लिया, कौन रायास है, कौन सुल्तान है, ऐसा हमने देख लिया. Now last topic is Nayakas. These are the military chiefs are called Nayakas. They usually spoke Telugu or Kannada. Many of the Nayakas submitted to the authority of the kings of Vijayanagara, but they often rebelled also. Okay, sometimes जब ज़्यादा powerful हो जाते हैं तो हो गया. Now Amara Nayaka system was a major political innovation of the Vijayanagara Empire. So who innovated or created this Amara Nayaka system? It is Vijayanagara Empire. Okay, it is likely that many of the features of this system were derived from Ikta system of Delhi Sultanate. Both important question है. ये जो Amara Nayaka system कौन से other system से मिलता जुलता है? ये है Ikta system of Delhi Sultanate. Okay. Now we are going to see what is this Amara Nayaka system. Amara Nayaka system were military pura theke yahan tak. Amara Nayaka system, Amara Nayakas were military commanders who were given territories to govern by the Raya. This is the first point. Unko ek territory milta hai govern karne ke liye. They collected the tax and other dues from the peasants, craftspersons, traders, and in that area. In subsequent tax solo lete. Second point, they retained part of the revenue for personal use and for maintaining their army, horses and elephants. So kuch ko le lete hain. These contingents provided the Vijayanagara kings with effective fighting force. Inke paas jo horses aur elephants, jo army rehta hai, wo inko ek effective fighting force, jab bhi inko koi battle ladna hota hai, they are ready to give. Some of the revenues also used for the maintenance of temples and irrigation works. So अमर नायका को एक लैंड मिलता है, उसमें ये लोग टैक्स लेते हैं और वहाँ पे लोग नो अपना खुद का मिलिट्री रखते हैं और मिलिट्री को कंट्रोल करने के लिए कुछ कुछ अमाउंट अपना पर्सनल यूज के लिए रख देते हैं और कुछ कुछ पैसे मतलब अपने टेम्पल्स का मेंटेन करने के लिए, इरिगेशन वर्क्स के लिए भी रखते हैं. और देन अमर नायका सेंड ट्रिब्यूट टू द किंग एनुअली एंड पर्सनली, एनुअली कुछ पैसा इनको किंग को देना पड़ता है और पर्सनली अपियर्ड इन रॉयल कोर्ट समटाइम्स विद गिफ्ट्स टू एक्सप्रेस देयर लॉयल्टी. And kings occasionally asserted their control over them by transferring. ये बहुत important है, इनका transfer भी होता था. Non transferable people नहीं है. जब भी किंग को लगता है कि बहुत ज्यादा इस एरिया में ज्यादा पावरफुल बन रहा है, तो तब भी क्या करता है वो किंग, या उसको उस एरिया से दूसरे एरिया ट्रांसफर करता है. दे आर लाइक प्रेजेंट डे आईएएस ऑफिस कलेक्टर्स के, द डिस्ट्रिक्ट कलेक्टर को हम आज कहते हैं, वैसे अमर नायक. लेकिन आज हम डिस्ट्रिक्ट कलेक्टर के पास आर्मी नहीं है, बट दे हैड देयर ओन आर्मी. एंड ड्यूरिंग दिस कोर्स ऑफ 17th सेंचुरी मेनी ऑफ दिस नायकास एस्टैब्लिश इंडिपेंडेंस. धीरे धीरे 17th सेंचुरी के बाद ये लोग अपना इंडिपेंडेंट किंगडम बनाने भी लग गए हैं. अमरा मीनिंग, अमरा इज अ वर्ड डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम द संस्कृत वर्ड कॉल्ड सामरा मीनिंग बैटल और वॉर. इट ऑल्सो रिसेंबल्स द पर्शियन टर्म कॉल्ड अमीर मीनिंग हाई नोबल. सो अमर नायका, द अमरा वर्ड इज कमिंग फ्रॉम टू वर्ड्स, सामरा मीनिंग बैटल और वॉर एंड पर्शियन वर्ड कॉल्ड अमीर मीनिंग हाई नोबल. सो दिस इज अबाउट अमर नायका सिस्टम. वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट थ्री मार्कर है ये. So these are the two, three paragraphs you have to summarize. Minimum four or five points you have to write about Amar Naayaka system. Okay. So in this video, we have discussed which are the questions. We have discussed two important questions. One long answer and one short answer. That's it. The rest all MCQs. That's all MCQs. So the next topic we will see in the next video, next session. Till then, all of you please take care and study well. Bye bye.